Do that with an outboard. Against these rocks. Drag, guys, we got something on first. Oh, I hope he didn't get off. Something's on. I think I lost him. Dad gummit. Yeah, golly. That's about as close as we're gonna get. Gonna try to fish this, I guess, the east side of this part of the river. All right, this is good. Don't see any other boaters up here, which is always sort of pleasant. But you hear that, oh gosh. No, don't need tangled lines, man. Ugh. Seriously? I'll be finally hooked up, I think. Yeah, we're hooked up. Man, it's been a hard, rough day of fishing, man. Put some night crawlers on this guy, so we'll see what we have here on the blackboard tip rigs. Yeah, a little small channel. Oh, just a couple of night crawlers. Hey, still, look at there, number four hooks, you know, night crawlers. Yeah, it's the first fish of the day. Small channel on the old night crawlers. And nothing on those livers just yet. So, sorry, I keep forgetting it. Gotta try to. These SW60s, man, they broke, man. Stinking the stupid whatever rope. the drag, the extra drag, it just doesn't quite work. So these are the black oil tip rigs again for this particular rod. I think something hit that guy. What's working best, so I got four night crawlers on a black oil tip rig that has, you know, this was the one that has a number two hook in the front and a number four hook in the back. Oh, there we go there. They just hung up. Okay, so tell you what, let's try to get him free before we finally something. 7 weight, guys. Been going down in hook sizes. We started with our big number three out hooks, then we went down to our number twos and number fours. Now we're all the way down to our number 10 brim hooks. It seems that the fish are still bites very slow, and we got something here though. Got some size to him, some strength to him as well. It's probably just another little, and we're fishing with the night crawlers right now. Might be a bass, who knows, man, in these waters. With this rig and this, and the way I fish, you know. 7 weight fly, look at how the whole rod bends. The whole rod bends, it's not just, yep, there we go. Yep. Wow, another light of blue. You see that, right? And what, are we fishing heavy line? No, tell you what. Finally, because I was like, oh my gosh, how are we going to pick this guy up, you know? Looks like they want the night crawlers today, guys. See, he don't like that net. Come on now. Seriously? That's a 7 weight fly rod. And that's definitely dinner. Alright. The wind is just, I decided to quit fighting the wind and just let it blow me whichever way it's gonna blow. Up, down, sideways, this way. And just let the rod stay perpendicular to the wind or the current, whichever one's strongest. But let's see what we can do here, guys. Sure happy to have this daggum net, man. Golly. And that's the one with a rattle in it. This tip rig is the one. This is, again, the Black Word tip rig. This is what I got with it. Nice blue, you know. So I'm going down in size on my hooks and going down in size on my tip rigs, and come on, guy, come on, dude. Now we're gonna get this guy out, because guess what? Once again, I forgot my stupid pliers. Think I'd learn, right? But nope, no. And that's a number 10 hook on a fly rod. It's got that. Got that rattle in it, but ooh, he's hooked too, in the corner of the mouth, just like you would with a circle hook. In the corner of the mouth, 8 pound line, 7 weight fly rod. And that's what you got. A nice eaten size blue. And he bit that almost, real subtle bite. Wasn't a heavy hit bite. So there we go. Not too bad. And I quit using two rods and went down to one rod. I find that more and more rods I fish, the fewer and fewer fish I catch. Now when you're drifting in the middle of the channel, be careful. Sometimes these boaters don't necessarily see you. I think he finally made a course correction there. But it can get scary sometimes. You're like, dude, I am fishing here. Move. So the net works. We gotta get the hook out. There we go. So that's pretty good for, you know, eating sized catfish. All right, let's get back on it. Not too bad, right? Get some of these nice, plump worms. I always keep them in here. Even though it's not particularly hot out, I always keep them in on there on that ice, man. It just works out better. This is, I love light action fishing. And this is, again, the tandem tip rig, except I have a rattle there. You may not be able to hear that. I know I can't because of the wind and the fact that I have earplugs in. You may not know, but I have earplugs in just like all the time when I'm fishing. Because I have the earplugs in because I'm, well, that didn't work out like I thought it would. I usually put two night crawlers on it. That guy went straight for cover here. Tell you what, why don't we just let that go like that? And we're getting close to the dam, to the old dam again. We're gonna just drift back down to where I put in, and then we'll just call it quits. Well, we're finally getting into something here, and we're just, we're still learning how to work with the wind. Let's see. The wind's sort of pushing me. Sometimes the wind is stronger than the current. Sometimes the current's stronger than the wind. You just have to pick which one goes and then do your drifting from there. And let that line hit the water like that. Easy. Pick it up like that once and we'll just put it back down. And then there we go. Just light fishing. That's the new rod. That's the 7-weight. We got the other rod here. Was using the hand lines, but golly, it's just that thick heavy line. Gosh, I didn't bring my heavy weights with me. So it was sort of, so let's reposition here. So as you can see, the line is, the wind's sort of pushing us this way. Well, was. Always depends. It's just kind of hard to say what's really happening. So, wind's sort of dying down again. So what I'm going to do is twirl all the way around here. See what that's gonna do. See what that'll do. Oh, that was stupid. That was like worse. Yep, so, but you can see what you can do. And that's generally why I like one rod. It's just easier, man. This is not going to help much. Coming up to the dam, you can see the low head portion of that dam. So we're going to reel in and cast. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now let's de-slime this line. We never de-slime the line. So there's our tandem tip rig. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and put that extra night crawler on there. Get a little bit of extra action and everything. The cool thing about keeping these worms on the ice also is that the worms come up to the top of the box. Makes it easy to find and get them. Instead of having to dig down to the depths of it, you just pick the juiciest ones you see on the top and be done with it. That guy, we'll put this guy right there on here. Basically the same. Kind of trying to figure out what's going on in terms of the current and everything. It's just kind of, it's another thing I keep doing. primary disadvantage with this rig and with combined with such a long rod is that it will I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna turn around. And I am gonna wait until I get on the other side of the dam here. That dam is very shallow and the water's starting to accelerate. Yep, it was greatly accelerating. It's like going over some rapids. You see how it is? This is the old dam. You see how the water's sort of calm right here? But you look right here and the water's just really rough. That's that old dam coming up. This time. Just let it down. And go from there. Instead of casting it behind us and get it caught up on the dam itself, we'll just let it down slowly. So that by the time it hits the bottom, we're on the other side of the dam and we'll be catching some fish, hopefully. It's a nice blue, right? An eating size blue with an eating size rod. That's exactly the kind of the size fish I plan to, I've always planned to catch with this particular rod. Eating sized. Dang. Wind doesn't know what it wants to do. Know if it wants to blow north, south, east, or west. We're gonna have to do it this way here until we get onto the bottom here. Yeah, that thing's just totally broken. It's not doing anything for me. Careful out here. These fishermen, they just don't, they got these big powerful boats and they just think this is a freaking drag strip, man. It's just he's not running too fast. Yeah, this thing's broken. Broken, it's just not even working. I've got the drag peeled all the way off and it's just not even working. So something in there ain't right. So we just, either we can fix it, but you know, considering for the price I paid for them, it's not even worth trying to send them back under warranty or anything. So, we may need to go back above the dam where we were and fish there, above the old dam, that is. It's tickling the bottom, which is what you want.